Yes, come in, please. Ah, Mr. Tolkien. Have a seat. I have something to discuss with you regarding your essay.
Oh, yeah. Is it the word count, sir? I'm aware I'm a little over at the moment.
No, it's not the word count. It's
oh,
just...
Oh, it's the seventh section, isn't it? I'm not sure if it's really relevant, but I really want it in there anyway.
No such thing. It's just
oh,
that you...
Oh, it's the lack of references. Yeah, I'm going to put some in. I just haven't yet. I'm sorry.
I'm glad to hear it, but...
Oh, it's the prose style, isn't it? I knew it was too meandering.
No, the prose is fine. It's just...
Oh, no. It's the extended influence from outlying historical figures, right?
Mr. Tolkien!
Yeah.
It is none of those things. My question for you is simply this. Why didn't they just fly to Mordor on the bloody eagles?
Oh, All the things you've said and all the things you've written, they just hit me right in the heart for you. You know what that's like, don't you? You're just such a sensitive man. I love a sensitive man.
An ASNaC name?
I suppose we should keep them in mind. What's in Norse section say?
Okay, well, there's. They list them alphabetically. There's Harold.
Oh, not too fond. What's next?
Harold.
Yeah, it's quite a few pages of Harold.
Does it have Olaf? You know, the name of a lovely neighbour down the road, and the name of the milkman, and the name of that rather unsavory chap who works for our other neighbour, Olaf, you know. Olaf.
Oh, yeah.
And the name of the Irishman who died down to the village, you know, Mr. Olaf.
It's a bit common, though. How about Sven? There's only 9 pages of Sven.
How about we don't pick an old Sven? What's on the Irish section?
Donacht.
Because we're tight.
Okay. Well, how about Mjögtak?
Oh, the other kids will make fun of him.
Well, I suppose we could call him Brian. We could nickname him Brian Moru.
Kane, honestly, don't be ridiculous. No one ever worthwhile is called Brian. What has Wales got to say for itself?
Sure, Wailing.
You just spat in my eyes.
You mustn't be so derogatory towards the other languages, darling.
Oh, no, Kane, and I'm sorry. It's just that I'm so hormonal with this little monster inside of me.
Well, I suppose we could go into England.
It's a bit desperate.
But how about Ethelbald?
Oh, that's obscure. How about one of the Brythonic
Recus names, Lycurian? You didn't want to call him Brian because it wasn't a glorious enough of a namesake. But you want to call him Urine, king of a country that doesn't exist anymore?
Well, I've heard that Bruday is quite an illustrious name in Pictland.
Oh, I'm not keen on that one. How about we go across the spine of Britain into the Dal Riada? Leslie!
Never heard of Leslie.
You've never heard of Canel Leslie of Cronesy? Darl, you must read the Daily Pictogram more often.
Well, back to England then, I suppose. How about Alfred? As in
Alfred the Great.
Oh, he's hardly going to be great, darling. He's descended from me. How about we name him after me? Tain!
Or how about we name him after me, Grendel's mum?
Ooh!
What shall I say of Avril, first of our prophets? She began her prophecy by saying, "Hey, hey, you, I do not like your girlfriend." And now with equal attention, this is a she who, before she was formed in the womb, was foreknown, was sanctified, and appointed a prophet among all nations. Listen, I say, to Beyoncé, who began her utterances as thus, "All the single ladies, all the single ladies. All the single ladies, put your hands up." She continued in this manner and said, "If you liked it, then you should have put a ring on it. If you liked it, then you should have put a ring on it." See also how the holy Carly cries out, "Hey! I just met you! And this is crazy! But here's my number, so call me. Maybe." What also lies in store for our future, for it is often said they have been to the year 3000. Not much has changed, but they live underwater. And your great, great, great granddaughter is pretty fine.
Amen.
However, beware too the trials of such earthly matrimony. As it is said, now you are just somebody that I used to know. Many times did the righteous prophet Adele speak, saying, "I set fire to the rain, watched it pour, as I touched your face." Here besides the word God spoke through his faithful servant Kesha, "I am going down, I yelleth timber." Listen also to what other famous prophets, the wonderful seers of the four beasts of the Gospels, have said of such suffering. Tragedy, when the feeling is gone, and you cannot go on. The prophets also speak of earthly temptation, sins of the flesh, saying, "Sweet dreams are made of this. Who am I to disagree? Indeed, who am I? Even such holy saints as these are not immune to such base and wretched desires, as they say, 'Oops, I did it again.' Even the great prophet, Will I Am, speaks thusly, 'I like to move it, move it.' And indeed, it is said, 'Let me entertain you.' For these desires are a curse from hell, and so spoke the blessed prophet Mark of such damnation. I am too hot, hot damn."
Well, let us turn from this! For marriage may be pure in the eyes of the Lord, and for not in tradition, but burn for a holy love for him. The prophet Shakira speaks of the purity of heart, saying, "My hips do not lie." And I said, as the village people did of old, and their prophet said thus, "Young man, there is no need to feel down. I said, young man, pick yourself up off the ground." For it was prophesied that those righteous in the eyes of the Lord will experience great bliss on the day of judgment, whereupon it will be said, "Everybody, rock your body, yeah! Everybody, rock your body, yeah! Backstreet is back!" All right. Indeed, from the blinking. Step into the sun. There is more to be seen than can ever be seen. More to do than can ever be done. And it is often said that, buddy, you're a boy. Make a big noise. Play in the streets. Gonna be a big man someday. You got mud on your face. You big disgrace. Kicking your can all over the place. Evermore praise thee and sing. We will rock you.
Such holy matrimony brings spiritual joy to those that walk the path of the righteous. The prophets often speak of such joy, saying, clap along. If you feel like a room, tell you, because I am happy. The holy Saint Macklemore also speaks of love and joy which knows no bounds, saying, so we put our hands up, so the ceiling cannot hold us. Or of a love that stretches to the heavens, it is said, I throw my hands up in the air sometimes. Saying, ale. The Blessed Katie also speaks to us, saying, baby, you are a firework. It's also said that righteous love should engulf the world, saying, we are young, so let us set the world on fire. Hear also what the Blessed Prophet Gaga says of love, saying,
ra 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 ra, Roma Roma ma ga. La 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 la.
Hello everyone, it is I, Dilda, and this is dedicated to five tyrants. You know who you are! And I have quite the time.
What's a good name for a tyrant? Decades! No, let's get this. Ah, baby. I'm big fan.
And who the hell are you?
Oh, I'm Bede, sir. I'm Bede.
Oh.
Yes, yes, I'm a big fan of your work, especially the early stuff, the history stuff.
Yeah.
I'm gonna make you famous, kid.
What about bloody time?
About the whole issue of consent. I mean, when we just go out and we start pillaging and raiding all over the place, it kind of hurts their feelings.
These are valid concerns, and I think that the issue of consent is one that we all need to work on. I'm looking at you, Harold.
But they've got so much booty, I'm sure they wouldn't miss just a little.
No, Harold, but they might miss the decapitated skulls that you've been collecting in your kitchen.
That's right, Harold.
I know about the skulls.
Yes, you can see why they might get
a little bit upset.
Exactly, thank you, Olaf.
I didn't say anything.
Oh, not you, Olaf. Olaf. Oh, hello, hello, suggestion, yes, please.
Ingvar?
Yes.
Is it burning? We've spoken about the burning, haven't we? What did we say about the burning? What did we say about the burning, Ingvar?
It's not okay to burn things.
It even says right here on the feedback box. To what extent was your raiding experience improved by the use of burning, where 5 is entirely enhanced and 1 is not at all? One thing, Bar, the proof is right here.
I put 5?
Well, there we
go. Pillaging!
Yes, I mean, no, not pillaging. That's sort of the point. So I think what we maybe need are some sort of workshops to help us put ourselves in the shoes of these monks so we can find a better way to deal with them moving forwards. Well, let's start with you, Olaf.
Me?
No, I mean Olaf.
Ah.
So you're sitting on an expedition to Iona or someplace, for example, and you're approaching a monastery and you want all of the booty that's inside. What do you do?
I do some stabbing.
No,
some hacking?
No, Olaf, I'm talking to Olaf right now. See, Olaf, the issue with stabbing is that we still have the problem of consent. Dead people cannot give consent. But you all got that.
Or me, please. Hello, idea, yes.
Okay, good. So how else might we deal with the situation? Olaf?
Well, we could...
Oh, not you, Olaf. Olaf.
Oh.
We could try talking to them.
That's very good, Olaf. What might we say?
Please hear hello!
Still my burning
in
mind.
No, give me all your booty.
Yes, that's a great start. But remember, the important thing is to respect the feelings of the monks. They've got to feel like their opinions are being taken on board before the aforementioned pillaging can commence.
Give me all your booty, please.
Don't laugh. Do you all see how this is so much better than stabbing?
Hello!
I tried to open it, but you mentioned burning one more time.
No! I was actually totally not going to suggest burning this one time.
Oh.
Yes.
Okay, then go on, Ingvar. Oh,
thank you. Mutilation! Right, yeah, with a sharp axe! You're going to...
How is this any different from stabbing?
Personally, I did not see anything wrong with the stabbing in the first place.
Me neither.
No, Harold, Olaf, that's not helping.
What?
No, I was talking to...
You know, personally, I mean for me, if we're just going to go ahead with the whole stabbing, pillaging, murdering, you know, I don't see the point.
See, I'm not 100% convinced about these monasteries anyway. I mean, all I got last time was this thin piece of animal hide with some stones and stuff on the front, but sure, nothing else apart from that.
I see your point, but I find that monk skulls tend to be of a far higher quality than so many dents and fractures. It's just not good.
But the thing is, if you then take your hook hand and then tie both these up to the ear, and then make life a little bit more easier when you stab them.
Wait, this meeting is over.
But like I was saying, with my hook hand, you scrape and you scrape and you scrape until it's at least done. And it's all very good. I mean, it's my favourite thing.
This is a demonstration of the Yelling Dynasty. This is a
Thank you.
Sing along,
yeah,
because it's the festive season, it's suitably morbid. Enjoy.